What's going on, guys? It's me, Marcus. Star Wars the Complete Saga. Now we're gonna be on we still got some things to do. Yeah, so I will actually start recording videos of these whenever I can because I have like other ideas for this. I bet you're wondering what this is. This is only multiplayer only. Two player arcade. Yeah. Anyway. Anyway. I forgot where we left off. Don't know where I'm at. Oh, yeah, right. Okay, we're on A New Hope. So let's. Okay, so now we are now on the next episode, which is A New Hope. So yeah. Oh God. Oh shit. Oh shit. Where'd they go? Darth Vader. Let's build these to unlock the door. But first, studs here. So if you pull this down, studs will actually come out. Keep on doing it. It's the more you do it, the more stud you will get. Like that. I just want to get some money. That's all I want to get. Okay. Now, Okay, I'm gonna shoot everything that I see here, because there are some stuff that we do need to get around here. Ugh. Okay, let's click these. And there they are. Yeah, so anyway, hey. Now we can get all the studs here. Yeah, you can purchase upgrades, which you can do later on in the game when you have the money. And if you have C-3PO, you can do that. Which, there are secrets in this game that you can use to have access to the double score zone. It means whenever you collect like hidden objects, so throughout the entire game and in every episode, you will find like lots of cool stuff that you can actually use, which you will be using later on in the game, like I said. You're gonna be using you're gonna be collecting studs a lot, because collecting studs allow you to unlock new characters, and each stud is like different. Then you pull these levers down. Then Vader leaves. Now, what you can do is collect these studs right here. Only bounty hunters can actually access those areas. Yeah, so like I said, when you unlock characters that are related to bounties, that is what I mean by the secret areas that I was talking about, because they will actually become useful later on in the game, because it allowed you to unlock cool stuff that you will like later on. You can unlock new characters, and each character has their own powerful level. So you can only access to these areas later on in the game. So let's keep wrecking stuff around here with Wreck-It Ralph. I saw that movie. Really funny. Ralph is my favorite character. It because he's really funny. It because he makes faces whenever he gets angry. It just turned out hilarious, and that's what I love about Wreck-It Ralph movie. Just so funny the way how I'm a Wreck-It Ralph. I'm a throw the temper tantrum. It's over fucking metal. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, if you pull these down, you can actually access in there later on in the game, like I said. Later on in the game, now we're a true Jedi, but I want to still collect some studs since that we're here. I want some money. Yeah, so when you get a true Jedi, you will actually get like high amount of studs right after you accomplish the game. Now these studs comes out. Let's get them. Now we're gonna come in here, then collect these. Then we push these right here. Then we're gonna come over here and save R2. Right there. Now we're stuck with this guy now. So I have So we're gonna just what you wanna do here that you wanna pick up these stormtroopers first and just drop them into the hole right there. Grab this other one. Anyway, guys, it's time to stop, so make sure to subscribe.